One of the most common questions asked for Microsoft Word is how to make one page of a document which is all portrait by default landscape. So you might want to do this if, for example, you have a large image which is a landscape image and you want to change the orientation of just that one page where the image is based and leave the rest of the document portrait. And that's what I'm going to show you in this particular tutorial. So you'll see here I have text and I have images in this document. The whole document is four pages of portrait orientation. And I want to make the third page landscape but leave the rest portrait so that this particular image of the bridge will sit on a landscape orientated page. So let me show you how that's done. Now, the first thing that's key to understanding how to work with page orientation is to look at section breaks. Now, by default, when you get to the end of a page in Word and then create a new page, it inserts what we call a page break. Now, when you go between pages, you can't necessarily see what type of break has been used between two pages if you're just glancing at the document. There's a couple of things you can do to help you out though. So if I right click on this bar at the very bottom and I'm going to go up and choose section, this will then allow me to see which section of the document I am clicking in. So you'll see as I click through, it remains at section one. So if I was to get down to the fourth page, I can see here that this whole document is one section, which is created by default when we use page breaks. The second thing I can do is click on this little option up here. So from the home tab on the ribbon, from within the formatting group, you'll see there's something called the show and hide option. Now this is really useful because it shows any formatting that's going on in your document. If I click show and hide, we will be able to see what type of breaks have been used in this document. So you'll see between page two and page three, there is a standard page break, for example. And there's also one between page three and page four, and there will be one between one and two, although it's not necessarily entirely clear here. What I want to do though is show you what people normally do, and then I'll show you the correct method for changing the orientation. So let's say, for example, we wanted the third page to be landscape. What normally happens is users will click on the page. So in this case, I'll just position the cursor just before the image. I'll then go up to the layout option. I'll go down to orientation and then I'll choose landscape. And oh, that looks great. The page is now landscape. However, so is every other page in the document. So I'm just going to undo that using the undo option. And let me show you the proper method. Now, essentially what you have to do to be able to change one page's orientation within your document is insert a section break either side of that particular page. So to do that, I'm going to go to the end of page two. I'm going to make a selection and get rid of this page break. So I've selected it and I'll press the delete key. Now, of course, the cursor jumps back to page three here. That's okay. I'm going to go back into page two. And what you want to do is you want to ensure that the section break you're going to insert is the last thing on the page. So if I've got no more text to go in here, then what I need to do is from the layout menu, you'll see we have breaks. Now within the breaks menu, there are a couple of different options. So standard page break or a column break. So you can have two columns, but keeping it all in one section, or you get a range of different section breaks here. Now what I'm going to do is, because I'm breaking the page at this point, what I want to do is I'm going to use the next page section break. So this will basically put a break in between the two pages, but instead of using a page break, it's going to use a section break and turn page two into section one and turn page three into section two. So I'm going to choose next page section break, and you'll see it tells me it's put the section break in here. And when I scroll down, now when I click on page three, you'll see it tells me at the bottom it's section two, but when I click on the page before, it tells me it's section one. So we now have two different sections, okay? What I'm now going to do here is I'm going to do the same thing again. I'm going to go into where it says page break down here. I'm going to press the delete key and take that out. I'll then put a little space in using a return. And then what I want to do is I want to use the breaks menu once again. And again, I'm going to use a section break next page. So now this page here, which is page four, which used to be section one originally, then became section two after we inserted the first section break, now becomes section three. So what we essentially have here is we essentially have section one, Then we've got a new section for page 3, and then we have section 3 from page 4 onwards. So because we've got a section break either side of this image, we will be able to change the orientation of this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on that particular page, and I'm now going to go up to orientation and click on landscape. And what you'll now see is we have that one page, which is landscape, and then the pages before and after are all portrait. And then the last thing I have to do here is perhaps just resize my image until it fits. And if I want to, I can maybe just position it in the center like that. So the key thing here is to understand how section breaks can be used to break your document up and allow you to change the orientation of one particular page within your document. Essentially, all you need to do is make sure you put a section break either side of that page and you'll be okay. I really hope you found that tutorial useful. If you did, please do consider giving it a like, and feel free to comment below if you have any questions about the process of changing the orientation of one page in Microsoft Word. I've got loads more video tutorials for Word, for Instagram, and for other software applications, web applications, and mobile applications on my YouTube channel. So please do feel free to watch those. And of course, if you haven't already done so, do subscribe and make sure you click on that notification bell so that you'll be notified about any future videos that I release. But thanks again for watching.